Morning.
Good morning, everybody.
Morning.
We just waiting for a few more people to join in. I'll have to turn the microphones off when I get in. Here we go. Okay, so today, I'm going to be doing the Shibashi again because people have said they like doing that. And Steve's going to be doing some of the session today on Zhang Zhong or standing post and Lohan patting, I believe. And then depending on how we're going on time, we'll round off with some form practice at the end as well, bringing all the ideas and the elements in together so you can see how, supposed to think of it this way, Tai Chi is a multifaceted art. It's not just a series of movements, it's not just a form. Each element of Tai Chi, whether it be qigong, standing post, Wang's five loosening exercises, rooting, push hands, weapons, whatever it might be, all the different facets of Tai Chi all feed in to body awareness and correct movement and correct alignment. And so we'll feed in everything that's happened in the session, and we start to look at putting it into the form afterwards. Because the form is the vehicle for you to test the elements out. It's a way you can put it into practice and start to tune your body and tune your mind. There's two wonderful terms that I learned a lot from working with physiotherapists. That's proprioception, which is connection to the ground, connection to your body. So when you put your foot on the ground, you know it's on the ground because it feeds back. And that position, and then kinesthetic awareness, so the positional awareness. So once we get used to the idea of positional awareness, the thing that enables us to realize when we pick a glass up, how to move it to our mouth, have a drink, and put it back down again, and what the distance is, and how we know touch the surface, that distance and positional awareness is key to how we function, and it reduces trips and falls. It makes it effective as a martial art, but more like a self-defense for life. It makes Tai Chi an effective method of allowing us to navigate through the world, to use this wonderful three-dimensional, multi-terrain vehicle called body, and helps us connect and strengthen the line, tone our muscles, help tone our core, help improve our flexibility and mobility for whatever reason you might want to do it. And so everything that we do all feeds that value. It's kind of, Tai Chi is a kind of musculoskeletal rehabilitation with a bonus prize that you can beat people up, which is pretty cool. So you choose how to do it. You either choose to beat other people up or you choose not to beat yourself up. Both are cool. All right then. So everything we do feeds into that vehicle. And if you practice the form just as a set of movements, it's quite relaxing. It's very mindful, it's very, very lovely. But it misses the wonderful gifts that Tai Chi brings to us. So as you practice with mindful attention to standing post or mindful attention to body positioning and releasing and engaging muscles and compression and all the other things that we've been covering, it all helps improve. Okay, Jenny, is to get full screen, if anybody else has the same problem, in the top right hand corner, there's a button. If you go near it, it'll say view, and it'll either say gallery view or speaker view. So you want it on speaker view because that'll be the main screen. Then if you have it on gallery view, you'll see everybody. So if you see lots of little boxes, that's because you've got it on gallery view. You should have one big screen with lots of tiny small boxes across the top. I'm not sure what it looks like on a tablet, but that's what it looks like on a computer. So if you've got one big screen, fantastic. If you've got lots of boxes in the right-hand corner, go over to where it says view, click on that and click on speaker view. Okay. So at the moment it'll be me, and shortly it will be, after we've done the qigong and stuff, it will be Steve. Okay. So last week, I thought it was fun to immerse myself completely in King's Heath Park. But my green screen is only so wide across the floor, so it meant that when I stepped forwards, I had no legs. So today, plus it's a lot of faffing for me, to be honest. So today, I'm just going to use the curtain on its own, but I've got a nice backdrop. Because we're getting towards that lovely spring, stroke summer weather, and sun shines out, and we're all looking forward to maybe mid to late April when we can start to go out more and on holiday. So I'm going to use a lovely background of a nice holiday place I like to go to and have been to before. and I'll let you try and guess what it might be. Then you can always message. That's all part of the entertainment. All right. But as usual, make sure you've got something to drink. Make sure you've got somewhere if you need to sit down. If you need to rest at any time, I'm just going to put my phone on silent. If you come on and you turn your microphone on, please turn your microphone off unless you want to speak, in which case you can turn it on, speak, and then turn it off again. Because otherwise we'll get lots of echoes and background noises and dogs barking and all the kind of usual stuff that happens. I think everyone's microphones look like they're off at the moment. It tends to be someone joins a little bit later and their microphone isn't automatically turned off. I don't know if I can do that automatically. It says it should do, but there you go. Let's have a look at a couple of comments this morning. It's all fine. Good. All right. We all set, we all ready. Yes. Music. Okay. So I'm gonna switch to the other screen. There we go. So I thought it was quite a nice picture this morning to do in Tai Chi. And I should do it on the grass. I'll probably do it on the grass. We have a bit of grass here, you know. Little bit of grass. We got a bit more grass this morning. Where's that? Over here, a bit more grass over here. Here we go. So we've got some grass this morning as well. Okay. I still have a little grass to get started. Music. Choose a different one today. Okay, here we go. Start bouncing, nice and loose, shoulders nice and relaxed. All right, that's done. We want to the big screen so I can see. There we go. Shoulders nice and relaxed. The aim is just to just bounce into your muscles. So straight up and down. You don't have to bounce really far, just nice and loose. Body upright. Need my air cut. There you go. Body upright. Bounce nice and loose. Arms up and turn. Nice and loose. Actually, just give me a second. Keep yourself nice and relaxed. There we go, nice and loose. swinging forwards. Like bowling a ball out. Pulling back towards you. Shoulders nice and relaxed, like you're pulling a rope towards you. Remember, this is the same as a number two exercise where you turn your waist, turn your hip nice and loose. And side to side. Remember, if you're joining in today online on Facebook, please remember to click like and click share so more people can join in. Shake. Say hello, type a comment, all helps. Shake. Stand on one leg, lift your knee, sit into the other leg. Rotate your ankle round and round and round. Up and down. Swing. Nice and loose. Circle round and round and round. Keep moving from the knee, other way round and round. You need the chair for balance, that's absolutely fine. Other leg, sink into your leg, lift your knee. Ankle round and round, round and round. Up and down and swing. And circle round and round. Knees and feet together, hands and hips, circle round and round. Shake. Rolling the shoulders. Nice and loose. Now, if you need subtitles because of hard of hearing, and if you watch this on YouTube afterwards, it automatically puts subtitles on for you. Circle over. Together, bend your knees, push, swing through, keeping your knees bent and your back straight. Nice and loose. Sitting into your hips, swing side to side. Rolling your shoulders. Forwards, backwards, knees forwards, curve through your body, looking round, drop, six times, hands together, push out, bend your knees, swing through. Remember, if you can't go this low, it's okay to stay this high. as long as you're not crushing your stomach, just bend your knees and sit in. Swing side to side. Rolling your shoulders. Lean forward, curl up. Give your body a shake, pull your trousers straight. So here we're gonna go through Shibashi set one. It means Tai Chi in 18 movements, or qigong in 18 movements. Number one, so you're breathing in. And as you breathe out, sing. Breathing in. All that beautiful sunshine behind me, and out. And in. And out. In. Breathe out as you bend your knees and sink. You can go as low as is comfortable. Breathing in, come up. Don't lock your knees, just stand up. And as you breathe out, bend your knees and sink down. Breathing in. And out. Once more, and down. Breathe in and open. All that lovely air, and out. Breathing in. Maybe you can put yourself stood like on the grass by the lakes, looking out to the sea. Breathe in. And out. Breathing in, all that lovely fresh air, opening your chest and out. Breathing in, elbows back, chest open, shoulder blades back. Breathing out, moving forwards and down. Six, here we go, in and out. Two more. And out. And once more. And out. And painting the rainbow, breathing in. And out. And in. And out. Just keeping the shoulders nice and relaxed. Just come and check how you're getting on. Keeping the shoulders nice and relaxed. That's right, shoulders nice and relaxed. That's great. Last one, and down. Breathing in, parting the clouds, breathing in and out. Keep breathing in, letting all that lovely sunshine in and out. And out. Sinking these lows is comfortable. If you can go all the way down, fantastic. But if you just bend your knees a little, that's great too. Circling your arms and parting the clouds. Once more, breathing in as you come up, and out as you separate, hands to your hips, and push, rolling arms, breathing in as you turn, out as you push, in, and out. And turning in, as far as it's comfortable, so I can still see both hands, out and a push. As far as it's comfortable, so I can still see both hands. And open a push. So if you're sitting down, you may just do it here to your hips if you're sitting down. Or you haven't got so much range of movement today. But otherwise, open and close. Open, turn it from the waist, shoulders relaxed, and push. Rolling arms. It's kind of like a big roller coaster. It goes over and dives and through. Over and dives and through. Like a roller coaster. Over and dives and through. If your shoulders are a little bit achy today, just do it lower. Keeping it below your shoulders. You just open the shoulders and turn. Open the shoulder blades and moving. You're not just rotating from here, you're opening the whole area. Shoulders feel a bit crunchy, a bit achy, just do it lower. Otherwise, over, almost like a big roller coaster shooting out. Keeping the fingers together, open. And roll. Always relax, always with a smile. In and out. Once more inside, in and out. Last one in and out. I'm rowing a boat across the lake, breathing in and out. In and out. Nice and gentle, in and out. Thank you. In and out. Once more, hands to your hips and holding the ball in front of the shoulder, breathing in and out, in and out. There we go. Body upright, knees bent, shoulders relaxed. It's almost as if you're holding a ball. That's why it's called holding the ball in front of the shoulder, shoulder hand. Breathing in and out. Let's check how you're getting on. There we go, all looking good. Loving the cape, Celia. Okay, poncho, let's say poncho. Okay, and in and out. Don't go so high, Margaret. Well, let's go above your shoulder height. There you go. Keeping the elbow down and open here. So when I turn, I'm quite open here. You can see open and so open here. All the time, keeping the joints relaxed and open, not too high. Last one. Turn to gaze at the moon, breathing in, bend your knees and out. In and out. Shoulders nice and relaxed. You turn to gaze at the moon. You turn to gaze at the sunshine behind me. Once more inside, breathing in and out. Last one, breathing in and out, and turn and push. Turn the waist and push the palms across. And push. I'm getting quite warm. Push. right. So push. Breathing in, hand to your hip. Turn and push across. In and out. You slow down a little bit, Mick. Slow down a little bit. There you go. Push. Breathing in as you pull your hand in. And breathing out as you push. In and out as you push. Breathing in and out as you push. You're looking good. You okay, Robert? Wave your hands in the clouds, breathing in and out. Maybe you make yourself stood by a beautiful lake on a hillside, just like I am. Turn, breathing in. And out. Breathing in all the lovely sunshine. Breathing in one direction and out. Once more inside, and just one leg forwards as you scoop the sea and look at the sky, breathing in and out. Breathing in. Scooping the sea, breathing in, out, looking at the sky once more, looking at the sky, pushing the waves, breathing in, elbows and shoulders back, and out as you push, so you can see, breathing in, and out, like waves crashing on the shore, out, breathing in, and almost if you can feel the waves crashing on the shore, and the undulating arms of the waves, push in and push and out. In and out. The flying dove spreads its wings, breathing in and out. In and out. Once more, in and out. Step shoulder width, bend your knees, hands to your hips, and punch. In and out. Push. Once more, punch and up. It's a flying goose, like I prefer flying swan. Breathe in. Making the way. Wings flapping and settling down as you rest on the lake behind me. In air, relax. Once more, and spinning wheel, breathing in and out, and in and out. In and out, change direction, in and out, in as you come up and out as you go down, and once more, in and out. And marching, bouncing ball, breathing in and out, and in, and out, and in, and out. Gathering the chi, all the energy in and out, and in and out. Gathering all the energy in to invigorate your body and mind, and out, and out. Once more in and out. Okay, give your hands a rub. Okay. Body shake. Make sure everyone's okay. Is everybody okay? Good, you good? Excellent, excellent. Okay. Steve, you ready? Go put your microphone on, mate. Go turn your microphone on, Steve. There you
okay.
Go.
Okay.
Fantastic. So now Steve's going to take over for this part of the session. Again, make sure, I'm just going to pin Steve as the speaker. So same thing applies. Just make sure you've got speaker view pinned. And I will pin Steve for the video. And there you go. Okay. So Steve, hopefully you've all got your love. Steve is a big image. If you haven't, if you just go up by his name, you'll see the dots. You just click pin speaker and then his image will come up as a big main picture. Okay. So ready when you are, Steve?
Yeah, is everybody okay that can see me all right? And hear me? Yeah. Okay, lovely. and I've got the music going.
Excellent.
So
set it up a bit.
Thanks.
In your own time, Steve?
Yeah, that's great. Yeah. Thanks, Mark. So for our first section of today, we'll be doing a meditation process, but we will be using standing post or Zhang Zhong. Standing post literally means standing like a tree. It's like a tree posture. You can have different poses with this, but the most universal common one is what I've just said, holding or hugging a tree. Okay, so from there, I'll just take you through the process. Standing posture has many benefits. Root is one of them. Root is the fundamental basics of Tai Chi. Without root, we're not stable. And it helps us to develop a root. Now, the Tai Chi classics say that the proper root is in the foot. So, as I said, a building without foundations, not stable. A tree or a plant without roots. Again, we're going to treat as if our feet are going into the earth, just like the tree roots, and our crown point suspended, as if the branches are lifting up into the sky. So really, we're going to just release our knees. And I'll talk you through the process as we go along, and I'll give you plenty of signposts, just paying attention to yourself for the next few minutes. Okay, so standing posture does go back about 3,000 years. As I said, it's very important. Externally, it looks like we're doing nothing, but as you know, Tai Chi is an internal art. So let's give it a go, and we'll start off. You can have your feet shoulder width, or you can have them a bit wider if you want to really strengthen your legs. Feet facing forward. And we're going to imagine our crown point suspended from above. And that crown point, the thread goes down into the earth. Shoulders relaxed. I'm going to focus on our dantian, which is probably about a couple of inches just below our navel. And the dantian is our energy center. Chinese believe it's where we store all our energy. So from there, what we're going to do is just relax, soften the knees, as if you're almost releasing the hips. And we're going to take a nice deep breath in. And we're going to bring our arms up in front of the chest, elbows down, shoulders relaxed. So from there, just soften your gaze or close your eyes. Just allow your exterior to become soft. I call this inner vision. So turn your mind inward. Just start to feel. Just be aware how you feel. Remember, we're creating a root in this practice. So feel your feet connected to the earth or grounded. Just breathing in and breathe out. Just feel at all times that you are releasing into the earth. If your shoulders or arms start to ache, just lower your hands for a few moments. Then we're going to find our strength through relaxation. There's many benefits. And keep your mind in a healthy and vibrant space. And the softness of your breath. Just breathing in and breathing out. Just let your mind follow your breath. Focus in on your center. Feel that connection to the earth. If you're reaching up into the heavens, if your mind wanders, just bring it back to your breath. just imagine that every time you're breathing in, you're gathering more energy, more life force, or chi. Feel all your muscles relax. Any tension, if you notice any areas of tension, allow that tension to drop literally into the earth. Any negative feelings, anything you don't want, just release down into the earth. You're now rooted, relaxed, calm and comfortable. Just breathe in, gather that energy. Breathing out, release tension. Just remind ourselves we're feeling strong through our relaxation. In fact, in these troubled times, we're feeling strong and resilient. Now we're going to lower our arms down towards our center, our dantian. Our hands rest either side, as if we're holding a golden ball of light. I'm just going to relax in this position. Then feel the crown point suspended. Keeping your posture in line, releasing tension. Just focusing for a few moments on your center. Feel that energy flowing gently and easily all around your body. I'm going to take a deeper breath in now and expand our hands away from our center. Feel that expansion through your body. Now release your hands back to your center. Return as you breathe out. Again, breathing in. We expand, breathing out. Next time, last one. Breathing in, we push down into the earth, feeling rooted and stable. And relax. I'm going to bring our hands up back again to finish in front of the chest for a few moments. Feeling focused, calm and comfortable. Softness of your breath. Shoulders, elbows relaxed. Feel stable, grounded. We're feeling good, allowing positivity and allowing bright energy into our life. We release ourselves from standing pose and we're going to finish with three good, vibrant breaths. We're going to bring and gather all the negativity, anything we don't want as we breathe in. And again, release everything down into the earth. Remember, we're releasing at all times into the earth. This time, as we breathe in, you have a positive, vibrant energy. Bring that into your body, into your life. And the last one, we'll seal everything in. And this makes it complete for you. Just rest with your hands on your center. Just relax, relax. Feel like your upper body is just empty. You just let everything go down into the earth. We're going to open our eyes slowly, being aware how we feel, releasing our hands and giving our hands and feet a good old shake. Everybody okay? Everybody feeling all right? Lovely. So remember, you can do that every day. It's part of a qigong routine. So it can be built into your movements, like you're doing with Mark earlier. Standing, just as important, you know, stillness as all the movements you've been doing. So it's worth doing, as I said, you build up a route over time, just 2 or 3 minutes a day. You can also do the step up, play guitar one, this one, or lift hands, you can swap over. Have the single weight in the back leg. Again, just relax. There's a lot of pictures of Professor Chow Manching in this pose. And he encouraged the roots. He's also does single whip. Creates like an openness, responsiveness. There's plenty of pictures you can see the professor doing. As I said, in the classics, root is important. The proper root is in the foot. Okay. So I hope you enjoyed that. I think I've got a few minutes left. I'm hoping we can do some low hand patting. Have we got time, Mark? Yeah, great. Lovely. So we're going to finish with low hand patting. Now, last year in the lockdown, I'll just give you a quick update of what I actually looked and researched low hand patting. Went online, there's lots of this going on. There's different styles, different things. So I wrote an article in the newsletter, which was last August. So if you've already, if not already read it, please do. You can access our newsletters online. Just sign up for them and we'll send them to you. Okay, so have a look at the newsletter. Again, a lot of benefits. It's supposed to stimulate the blood circulation. Also the meridian pathways, acupressure points. So we've got strengthens. Now, yeah, recently I saw some videos before Christmas, people claiming that it strengthens the immune system, which can't be a bad thing. So I think it's worth doing it, worth having a go. And also boosts the overall energy in the body. I did it quite frequent most days, and I felt like it gave me more vitality, boosted my energy. It felt good afterwards. Feels a good thing to do. And I mean, when we used to hug people, remember that in the old days? We hug people, you sort of pat people. Maybe if we bang our arm or leg. We sometimes brush, like a self-massage, rubbing it or patting it. Yeah, as I say, it should only take a couple of minutes. You can do as many as you like, but as long as you like, we'll do a shorter version. So let's start then. What we're going to do, bear with me, get your notes there. So we'll start with the outside of the arms. So put one arm out, gonna go up and down. Now we've got here the triple burner meridian. That's a major meridian, benefits that. Also for the stomach and large intestine. If we turn over on the inside, part of the lung areas. You go on the shoulders as well if you wish. We'll swap over. Up and down. Some people prefer to karate chop, or just have a loose fist. I just think this is a nice, the patting, gentle patting. Again, inside. And then underneath the arms, the armpits area, we've got for the spleen and lymphatics, just a few each side. As I said, you can do as many as you like. And then we'll move down into the mid, into here. Round about where the diaphragm, below the ribs. This is for the liver and spleen. There's 12 major meridians, 12 paired meridians running around the body, along with all the acupressure points going down onto the midsection of the stomach, down towards your centre. Now we've got tops of the legs. This helps with the blood flow from the upper to the lower and lower up. Onto the hips. This is for the gallbladder. And we're going to go down the outside of the legs for circulation. Just patting down the legs. Now come up the inside. Again, back onto the hips. So gallbladder, down the outside. As far as you can go, don't strain too much. Up the inside. And then the buttocks. Now you've got a bladder meridian running through there. We're going to move on to the face. Now the jawline, you've got a few acupressure points here. Just a gentle pat. Good for complexion. Here, the head for sinus or headaches. and the back of the head, just at the base of the neck, where the skull, base of the skull rather, again for headaches. Chinese beliefs where the pathogens enter the body, it's an important area. Then we move towards onto the ears, where you've got lots of acupressure points. So we're squeezing the outside, inside. And then between the eyes, we're nearly finished. So between the eyes, we've got the bladder meridian, just a gentle tap. You've got glasses, you can move your glasses or side of the eyes, gallbladder. Just a few taps there. Underneath the eyes, we've got the stomach meridian. And then we've got here, the upper lip, the major meridian. It's called the governing vessel. It's good for the brain. Then the lower lip, conception vessel. This runs down the front of your body. And then we're going to tap here for the kidneys up by the collarbone. Couple more to do. The thymus gland here, middle of the chest. This is part of the endocrine system. Good for stress, anxiety. Can do a few deep breaths with this one. Thyroid, base of the neck, which is tap around the base of the neck. And we're finished. We're making two loose fists, rubbing the adrenals on the back, the kidneys, and tapping the kidneys gently. And then give your hands and feet a shake. Thank you very much. Namaste. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed that.
Lovely to hear your voice, Steve.
Thank you.
Right, here we go. Thanks, Steve. It's great. I really appreciate you doing that today. The more that people start to see us all back again, the more that we're all getting used to getting back in the parks or in the classes. It looks like, well, fingers crossed, end of March, beginning of April, we're going to start going out. Steve will be doing a Bourneville Park. So if anybody's been attending Roe Heath, that's going to move down to Bourneville. But at the same time, Thursdays at 1 o'clock. And Steve will be running that. So if you used to go there, please do. If you used to go to any other classes, you've maybe gone to Cottridge and you'd like some additional class, 1 o'clock with Steve. Just turn your microphone off, Steve.
Can you hear me? It will be 12 o'clock, like Roe.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. I apologise. That you're absolutely right.
Yeah. Same as Roe.
Same as Roe. 12 o'clock, yes. That's good. Yeah. Easy to get from one to the other.
It is, yeah.
Excellent. All right, then. Well, great. Thank you very much, Steve. I hope you're enjoying this. The aim is, like, next week, Rob's going to do some, and then the week after John, and then the week after Lynn. And then before we know it, we'll be end of March, beginning of April, and some of us will be able to go back outdoors again. Now, if you... we may try and do... still do the Zoom as well for those who can't attend. I'm not sure whether the technology, 4G, 5G, whether that'll do the job or not. Just have to wait and see. But otherwise, we'll see you all again soon. Remember, all these classes that we do, after the sessions, they all get uploaded onto YouTube. So if you can't do it now, or if you're doing it now, remember, the more you practice, the more you gain. It is the more. Like Steve just said, you practice this low hand pattern most days and invigorates your body. The more you practice, the better it becomes. One of my friends, a good friend, Dan Doherty, was really struggling with his health, and he started practicing Bad Blood Gin every day, and it helped him massively. It's very easy to get into the habit of thinking, well, I've been practicing for years, so I'll just do a bit now and again. It's like all forms of exercise, the more. It improves your tone, improves your energy levels, release of endorphins, release of serotonin, improves circulation, improves stability, improve flexibility. There's so much that exercise gives us for our physical and mental health. So please try and practice every day. The videos are there for free. You just go on and watch them. The link's there. And we set up a specific YouTube playlist just for these classes. So you don't have to trawl through all of our videos. Just click on the COVID classes playlist, and you can just watch all the ones we've been doing. Well, thank you all, and we'll look forward to seeing you all next week.
Mark?
Yes?
Mark, for those who can't get down to you, will you continue this Zoom class?
Well, this is the time that I normally do Tai Chi in the park.
Yeah.
So the aim is I'm going to try and use my phone on 4G, 5G to make this on Zoom as well, so you'll still be able to join in from the park.
I'm going
to
give that a
go. See how that is.
Thank you.
Okay. Thanks for asking, Margaret. Otherwise, I might start an evening Zoom class until we can all get back open again. This is really to continue supporting us. Each of the classes gradually starts to open. We can get more outdoors. If I'm not able to make this class available live from when I'm in the park over the Wi-Fi or over my 4G, then I'll start to look at doing an evening class that people can pay for and join into there. So thank you all very much.
Is the article that Steve mentioned on Painting the Rainbow website?
Yes. Painting the Rainbow, yes. All the classes will be listed on there. You'll see a list of the parks, and that'll be updated shortly, where we can find which ones.
The one that Steve mentioned about the tapping technique.
No, that's called Lohan patting. You need to go to a class to do that, or look it up on YouTube, or just message Steve. But we do it sometimes in classes. What we would say is, go to a class. It's not on Painting the Rainbow website, but obviously this video will be up on YouTube, so you can watch that and join in there.
As I said, you can read my article in August last year. Give
you
a bit more detail.
So if you go on to qigong.co.uk, scroll down to the bottom of the page, click on newsletters, or just Google Tai Chi newsletters, and you'll find taichinewsletters.co.uk, and you go down, you find August 2020, and then you'll see the article by Steve.
Thank you, Mark, for all your efforts. Thank you, Steve. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, bye everybody.
Bye. Bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye all.
Bye all.
Thank you.
Thanks, Steve.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mark. Thanks, Steve.
Thank you. Thank you, Mark.
See you next week.
Thank you.
Cheers, Bob.
Also, thanks to you, Rob. Excellent.
Bye all.